39er Quebec, cross to Rixie at 3000 cleared, RNAV, runway 2000 left approach.
Rixie at 3000 cleared for the approach, 39 Quebec.
Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics. This can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Grand Forks International is a medium to large-sized multi-use airport located 5 miles west of the city of Grand Forks, North Dakota. Grand Forks serves as the region's air transportation hub as well as being home to the University of North Dakota's nationally recognized flight training program. It has Class Delta airspace extending from the surface to 3,300 MSL. 7 miles west of Grand Forks is the Grand Forks Air Force Base, Romeo Delta Romeo, which has a unique temporary flight restricted zone for conducting UAS operations and Class Delta airspace extending from the surface to 3,400 feet MSL. Check NOTAMs prior to departing for Grand Forks for the latest information. The combination of complex airspace and a diverse traffic mix consisting of everything from pre-solo students through high-time air carrier pilots and their associated aircraft makes Grand Forks a challenging airport for both controllers and pilots. The runway configuration consists of two sets of parallel runways with staggered thresholds. Runways 9er and 27 left and right and runways 17 and 35 left and right border all of the terminals, facilities, and businesses located at the airport. Parallel taxiways are found by each runway. Airports with this type of runway and taxiway configuration are prime candidates for wrong surface operations. Extra attention needs to be paid to ensuring pilots are lining up for the runway on which they are cleared to operate. Due to intensive student pilot activity, unique traffic pattern entries are used at the airport. Transient pilots need to ensure they understand and can comply with the tower's instructions. If you are in doubt or unsure of what to do, ask the tower. They are there to help and would rather spend an extra transmission to ensure the safety and efficiency of their traffic flow. Hotspots 1 and 2 concern the same type of issue at two different locations. Pilots cleared to taxi via either taxiway Alpha or Bravo hold short a runway, have missed the hold short bars, and crossed the runways. Clear understanding of taxi route, turns, and hold short points before you taxi, along with continuously scanning outside the aircraft for markings and signage, will help pilots avoid this potentially catastrophic error. Grand Forks also has a robust helicopter training community. Numerous areas around the airport are utilized for these operations. Transient pilots need to be prepared to see these operations in the following areas, depending on runway configuration. Taxiway Alpha, between Alpha 1 and Alpha 2. Taxiway Bravo, west of runway 35 left and east of taxiway uniform, but short of runway 17 left. Taxiway Charlie, between Charlie 2 and Charlie 3. Taxiway Echo, just south of Charlie 2 to just north of taxiway Sierra. And in the designated helipads, located south of Charlie 2, east and west of taxiway Echo. In addition to these specific areas for helicopter operations, fixed-wing pilots should expect to see a large volume of helicopter traffic, both inbound and outbound, and in the pattern between the parallel runways. Due to the high concentration of pilot training and flight schedules, and primarily when the airport is departing south utilizing runways 17 left and right, departing aircraft can expect congestion at the run-up areas, on taxiway Bravo, short of Alpha for runway 17 right, and Charlie for 17 left. Pilots should note that the taxi lane between the Bravo apron and the Charlie apron on the northeast portion of the airport was previously a single taxi lane, which resulted in the need for alternating northbound and southbound traffic. However, this taxi lane now has two lanes, which allows for simultaneous two-way traffic. Similar to a vehicular roadway in the United States, keep to the right. Northbound traffic utilizes the lane to the east, while southbound traffic uses the lane to the west. This area is not controlled by air traffic control, and the taxi lane configuration can support aircraft with up to a 42-foot wingspan. Grand Forks Tower is not open 24 hours. Check NOTAMs and the chart supplement entitled North Central U.S. for the hours of operation. When the tower is closed, pilot control lighting is available on runways 17 right 35 left and Niner left 27 right only. Additionally, runways 17 left 35 right and Niner right 27 left are closed when the tower is not in operation. With seasonal complexities such as construction and snow at Grand Forks, be sure to always check NOTAMs and thoroughly review them for closures, unusual operations, and other potential changes. It's important to note that this should always be done, regardless of the season or field conditions. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Grand Forks will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the air traffic control tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Grand Forks International Airport. It's always better to know before you go.